The first time you watch the 80s classic The Breakfast Club, you probably won't find much story structure. But if you watch it again and again, you'll start to notice moments that mirror typical storytelling patterns. And there is one moment, a moment that is undeniably genius, that is so subtle you still might miss it. Because The Breakfast Club's most important part isn't its unforgettable characters. It's this totally forgettable door. So let's talk about how they broke the rules and why. This is Unstructured by Plotwell. To understand why this door is so crucial, let's first cover what the movie is about. The Breakfast Club follows five teenagers trapped in detention on a Saturday. There's no big plot, big cast, or big set. In fact, there's only 14 actors, and half of them aren't in more than a shot or two. And of the movie's 92 minutes, almost 95% is set in the school, and around 80% is set in the library. That's a lot of time in one location. This, on its own, is uncommon. Usually movies switch locations often, and there's almost always a big location change at the 25% point. This is because in three-act structure, the break between Act 1 and Act 2 usually comes in at the quarter mark, and a staple of this act break is a large external change. For example, in Legally Blonde, our protagonist Elle Woods breaks the acts by moving across the country to Harvard University. But in The Breakfast Club, there is no location change. Act 1 takes place mainly in the library, and Act 2 takes place mainly in the library. So the question is, how do you separate your acts with a large external change when you're stuck in one location? Enter the door. In a scene just before the quarter mark, student Bender steals a screw from the library's door to keep it from staying open. The antagonist, Vice Principal Mr. Verdon, tries to lodge the door open to no success, and after a few minutes leaves and the door remains closed. It doesn't seem like much, but this scene accomplishes a lot. First, it delivers us a large, albeit subtle, external change, and second, it allows the story to actually start. In story structure, the break between Act 1 and Act 2 highlights the shift from the normal world of Act 1 to the dangerous and different world of Act 2. For example, in Jurassic Park, the helicopter ride breaks up the normal dig site of Act 1 and the incredible and dangerous Dinosaur Island of Act 2. It may not seem like it at first, but the Breakfast Club's door scene is actually doing a similar thing. The library in Act 1 is relatively quiet and orderly. The kids aren't able to move around too much or talk too loudly, as Vernon's door is right across the hall. But once the door closes, the kids have a lot more freedom to move around the library and even start sneaking through the hallways. From this alone, you can see there is a clear difference between the orderly world of Act 1 and the chaotic world of Act 2. The break between Act 1 and Act 2 is also used to mark the moment the adventure starts. As a clear example, let's look at Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. Act 1 is very unadventurous, as Charlie and the other children slowly find golden tickets. It's not until the shift to Act 2, when the children enter the Chocolate Factory, that the story gets interesting. This is not unlike The Breakfast Club. The first act is pretty uneventful. It's not until the kids are given more freedom that we meet them, that they butt heads, and that they really start breaking the rules, like sneaking through the halls and smoking up. And none of this would be possible if the door was still open, as Vernon would be able to see and hear the kids. In other words, the door closing allows the adventure to begin. So what makes this movie so different to other stories set in one location? To see why The Breakfast Club is so special, let's compare it to Alien. Alien is set on one spaceship, a contained environment like The Breakfast Club's Shermer High School. But in Alien, the break between Act 1 and Act 2 is the introduction of the alien onto the ship. In other words, something from outside is brought inside, changing the world of Act 1 into the world of Act 2. But in The Breakfast Club, nothing new is introduced. There's no new character, or intergalactic predator, brought in to shake things up. There's just a door, and a screw, and a mischievous protagonist, and a tiny change that shoots the story in a whole new direction. So even though The Breakfast Club doesn't shift locations at its act break, it still manages to accomplish the same goals. By using a subtle change, like a closed door, the movie gave its characters more freedom, allowed more excitement, and marked a shift between its orderly Act 1 and its chaotic Act 2. Yes, an epic helicopter ride is cool, but sometimes a door is all you need.